Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video we will practice order related transaction data case that was asked in one of the Power BI exam. And the question is, you are building a Power BI report that uses data from an Azure SQL database named ERP1. You import the following tables: products, that contains product catalog details. Then next table we have is orders, that contains high level information about orders. Then the third table we have is order line items, that contains product ID, quantity, price details of an order. You need to perform the following analysis on this data. The first analysis is orders sold over time that include a measure of the total order value. And the next analysis is orders by attributes of product sold. The solution must minimize update time when interacting with visuals in the report. What should you do first? And the available options are from Power Query, merge the order line items query and the products query. The second option is create calculated column that adds list of product categories to the order table by using tags. The third option is calculate the count of orders per product by using a tags function. And the last option is from Power Query, merge the orders query and the order line item queries. Now let's look at the given data and use case first. So here we can see we have three tables, product, orders and order line items, where product contains the product related information, orders contains the order related information, then order line items are the detail level order details. So now let's look at the data in the Power BI. So here in Power BI you can see we have three tables, order line items, where we have order ID, product ID, quantity rate, order amount and other details. And under order tables, we have order related information like order ID, who is the customer, then order date. And the third table is the products, where we have product name and product ID. Based on the given requirement, we have to achieve two analyses. First is the orders over the date trend, and second is we need orders by product ID. So as an ideal solution, we should create a relationship to achieve this requirement. So for that, we need to go to the Power BI desktop. And here in a Power BI desktop, under model view, we need to create a relationship between these three tables. So here from order to order line items, the relation is the based on the order ID. So let's make this relationship. And then from product table, we have product ID in the order line items. So now this relationship is also created. Now under report view, we can plot the required two analyses. The first required visual is the order value trend over the time. So for that, let's select the line chart. And let's select the date. And we need the amount. So from order line items, we can select the order amount. And let's remove the hierarchy. So now here we have a line chart where we can see the order amount over the time. And the next analysis is the order amount by product. So for that, let's add one visual. And this visual type should be matrix. And here we need order amount. And from product table, we need product. So here we have order amount by the products. So with this, we can achieve this requirement by establishing relationship between these three tables. But here, the creating relationship is not given in the options. So we need to think from different perspective on this use case. So here, instead of minimizing the data model, the emphasis is on the reducing the interacting time on the visuals. So when we want to reduce the interaction time on the visuals, then we have to shape the data under transformation itself instead of creating a relationship in report view. So now let's remove this relationship. And let's go back to the transformation editor. Now here, based on the relationship that we created in a report view, we need to merge these three tables. So for that, let's go to the merge queries. And here we need to merge order line items with the orders. And the relationship is based on the order ID. So let's select the order ID and OK. Now we have merge table. So let's rename this table as the order details. And now we need products as well in this table. So let's merge product as well. and the relationship should be on the product ID. And let me expand these two tables. Now we have merged and flattened all the three tables as a single table in order details. Now let's go back to the report view and plot analysis. Now based on the column names, Power BI has created all these relationships, but we don't need all these relationships as we have all the data under order detail table. So let's ignore this relationship and let's go back to the report view. Now here under the trend, we need to pull the fields from the order detail. So here first we need to pull the order date. And amount should also come from order details table. And now here you can see we are getting same trend from order details table. Now let's update the second visual. Here we need to change the product name with the product name from order details table. And same way this order amount needs to be changed from the order details. And here we can see we are getting order amount by products. So with this, we are able to achieve both the visuals from the order detail table. And since all the data is from single table, the interaction would be fast. So now let's go back to the question. So here under transformation, we did two steps. The first is option A, that we merge order line items with product table. And the option D, that is in Power Query Editor, we merge order query with order line items query. So the correct answer is the option A and D. But here in the question, we can see it is not given that we have to choose two options. So if we need to select only one option, then we should select option D.